Hi guys, and welcome to my channel. For those who are new, my name is Helena Fergamon. In this tutorial, I will show you how to create this very simple, versatile, fast crocheting and attractive looking stitch. It creates by forming V-shaped stitches, it has great elasticity, and it can be incorporated into modern pattern as well as complement the vintage look. On top of that, it can be used in uncountable possibilities of project and combined with other stitches as well. This piece is part of my Shrug Bolero project I'm working on, and the free pattern to follow will be available in a few days time. And if you are watching this video in later days, then the design is already in my base. To begin, create a slip knot and chain 17 stitches. After chaining up, add additional 3 chain stitches to begin a new row. The first stitch will have to be crocheted into the 6th stitch from the hook. You can work into top loops or turn your work and work under the bumps. Yarn over and work 1 treble crochet UK terms or 1 double crochet US terms into the 6th stitch from the hook. Chain 1. Yarn over and work 1 treble crochet UK terms or 1 double crochet US terms into the same stitch. Skip 2 and work 1 treble crochet UK terms or 1 double crochet US terms into a stitch. Chain 1 and work 1 treble crochet UK terms or 1 double crochet US terms into the same stitch. Skip 2 and work 1 treble crochet UK terms or 1 double crochet US terms into a stitch. Chain 1 and work 1 treble crochet UK terms or 1 double crochet US terms into the same stitch. Skip 2 and continue forming the pattern by creating V-shaped stitches. When you come to the end of the row, after last V-shaped stitches, you should have 2 chain stitches left. Skip 1 and finish with 1 treble crochet UK terms or 1 double crochet US terms into last stitch of your work. To begin a new row, chain 3 and turn your work. If you turn your work clockwise, your chain will be twisted, then you will have to reposition the hook. If you turn your work anti-clockwise, you don't have to reposition the hook. Continue crocheting. Personally, I have the tendency to turn my work clockwise, especially when I'm working on a small samples. We have 3 chain stitches to start the row. Work 1 treble crochet UK terms or 1 double crochet US terms around 1 chain stitch. Chain 1 and work 1 treble crochet UK terms or 1 double crochet US terms around the same chain stitch. Continue to form V-shaped stitches on top of the other V-shaped stitches. Continue your practice on your swatch sample. Thank you for watching. I hope you've had great experience. For those who are new to my channel, if you'd like to see more videos in the future, please subscribe to be notified when I add a new video. Enjoy your day or evening, and I will see you soon.